Back with another video for you today, and it is Designer Month. And today, in this Saffron contributor review video, we're taking on a classic. It is Azzaro Pour Homme, this one right here. You're going to have a chance at winning a full bottle of Azzaro Pour Homme as well. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Sebastian with Smelling Great Fragrance Reviews. If this is your first time on this channel and or you've been watching videos for a while and still haven't subscribed, please click the subscribe button below and also that bell so that you'll be notified for future videos and giveaways. And yes, this is a classic fragrance. This is Azzaro Pour Homme. Now, this one brings back lots of memories for me. Both my dad and my uncle wore Azzaro Pour Homme. In fact, Azzaro Pour Homme was my uncle's dating fragrance. He would wear this and go on dates, and the ladies would love it on him, and they would go out to clubs to dance and things like that. As a kid, I loved the way this smelled, and I loved it when he wore it to go out at night, because when he left, I would find his bottle and spray some on me, because I loved that green vibrancy. The big, bold notes in here were just really get to me, and I enjoyed it a lot. So I wanted to review it for you here because this is a historic fragrance. Now, this is the second release from the House of Azzaro, the designer house. Their first fragrance came out a few years prior. It was a ladies' fragrance, but the second fragrance that Azzaro launched was in 1978, called Azzaro Pour Homme. This is a 100ml bottle. It is eau de toilette concentration, and it's suggested retail for $85. This is a aromatic Fougere fragrance, and we've spoken a lot about Fougere fragrances on this channel, and it's one of my favorite styles of fragrances because of the lavender, the oak moss, and the tonka bean in the notes. But here with Azzaro Pour Homme, at the top you've got bergamot, lemon, and star anise. Now, star anise is kind of the unique twist to the aromatic Fougere of Azzaro Pour Homme. In the heart, you've got patchouli, of course the lavender, and vetiver. And then finally in the base, you've got the amber, sandalwood, tonka bean, and musk. So if you don't know what fougères are, the word fougère basically stands for fern in French. Now, the very first fougère came out in 1892 when Paul Parquet created Houbigant's Fougère Royale. He basically extracted the synthetic component from the tonka bean called coumarin because he was trying to make the smell of ferns, because ferns don't really have a smell. So he was trying to recreate a smell that really didn't exist. So basically what coumarin smells like is fresh mowed lawn, so that he wanted to add that fern-like smell to the fragrance of Fougère Royale. Azzaro Pour Homme is a little twist on the original Fougère Royale. For me, Azzaro Pour Homme has a little twist because it has like the 70s and 80s powerhouse twist in the smell of the fragrance. It doesn't smell at all like Fougère Royale, even though it has the typical note breakdown of the lavender in the heart and the tonka bean in the base. But this one actually is spiced up with that top note of star anise. This is a big note here in this fragrance, and it does a really great job. Absolutely love that part about it, because it does have a little bit of a licorice-y twist to it, and it's pretty darn amazing. And that's, I think, what really resonated with me with this fragrance, because star anise, or you know, licorice in general, was something that I consumed as a little kid, so I began to love the way that smelled. So here, it plays a major role, and you've got to love that. And I'm sure a lot of guys do, because this is, after all, a very, very popular and successful fragrance in the history of men's fragrances. And that's why it still exists, I mean, after so many years from first being launched in 1978. The lavender kicks in the heart. Of course, you know that lavender is pretty big here as well. It's mostly about the lavender and the star anise. And then you've got, of course, you've got the amber and the vetiver. The vetiver is also another major player here. And the vetiver actually adds this like earthiness to the fragrance. And then as it's drying down is when it's really becoming earthy and woody. And the best part about this fragrance is its dry down. I absolutely love it, and I think it's because of the dry down I get compliments with this one. People do turn heads when you're wearing this, and when I'm walking around people in the city, or you know, at the metro and things like that, people turn and say, hey, what are you wearing? And you tell them, hey, it's just Azzaro Pour Homme, it's a classic from the 70s, and they go, oh yeah, my dad wore that smells great on you, things like that. I also want to mention there are two flankers that came in the last 4 to 5 years that are related to the Azzaro Pour Homme classic. One came out in 2015. It's the Azzaro Pour Homme Intense in EDP, which I absolutely love. Absolutely love that one. It is a new take on this original one, and it's boozy. Like, if you like boozy fragrances, it's got like these liqueur notes in it. It is heavenly. It is, I'm surprised nobody speaks about that one. I think maybe because it's just a classic, but you have to try the EDP from 2015. It's delicious, actually. And finally, last year, they launched a flanker called Azzaro Pour Homme Edition Noir, which I also really like. So hopefully we'll do some reviews for those two in the future. But in the meantime, if you haven't tried Azzaro Pour Homme Eau de Toilette from 1978, we have a link in the info box. Click that link, go to Saffler Bond, and participate in the full bottle giveaway there. Just make sure you follow the rules and do as they request so that you qualify for the giveaway. All right, guys, what are your thoughts about Azzaro Pour Homme Eau de Toilette from 1978? Have you worn it? Have you liked it? Do you have it currently in your collection? Did your dad or a relative wear it? Let us know so we can get a conversation started. Also, please like this video. Please share it. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and I'll be back with more videos very soon. Have a good one. Goodbye.